हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, ऑफ कोर्स माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीई सिक्स सेमेस्टर इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, टुडे वंस अगेन आई एम हियर विथ यू विद दिस वीडियो प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग विथ आईआईआर फिल्टर्स न्यूमेरिकल्स पार्ट वन। माई सेल्फ हियर ललित कुमार पी भैया, Associate Professor, Electronics and Telecommunication Department, Bharati College of Engineering and Technology, Durg. Dear student, last time we have seen about this IIR filter design, infinite impulse response filter, and we also have finite impulse response filter. Today we will discuss the numericals of this IIR filter design. Already we have seen the standard approach for the IIR filter design. Here three points are given: convert the digital filter specification into an analog prototype low pass filter specifications, determine the analog low pass filter transfer function, that is HAFS, and replace this HAFS by H of Z using various design techniques. We have seen basically three types of design in this IIR filter. One is the impulse invariance technique, second one is the bilinear transformation, and third one is the approximation of derivatives. This approach has been widely used for the following reasons. Analog approximation techniques are highly advanced. They usually yield closed form solutions. Extensive tables are available for analog filter design, and very often applications require digital simulation for analog system. Let us go through this numerical of IIR filter. You can see this problem. The system function of the analog filter is given as HA of S is equal to S plus 0.1 upon S plus 0.1 whole square plus 16. Obtain the system function of the digital filter using bilinear transformation, which is resonant at omega r is equal to pi by 2. Dear friends, this was the numerical asked number of times in electronics as well as in electrical engineering. Here we have to design this filter. The analog transfer function is given and the approach is also given, that is bilinear transformation technique. And here this resonant frequency omega r is equal to pi by 2 is also given. So first of all, what we will do, we can determine the poles of this analog filter, which is given in this denominator of the given transfer function. So S plus 0.1 square plus 16, we make it fractions and calculate the roots and calculate the poles. These poles are S is equal to minus 0.1 plus J4 and S is equal to minus 0.1 minus J4. This is complex conjugate pole. And the real value of this complex conjugate pole are this sigma is equal to 0.1 and frequency, that is omega, is plus minus 4, this one. So this is sigma plus minus j omega. So you can have this plus minus 4. A function is said to be resonant at its poles. Therefore, HA of S will resonant at S is equal to minus 0.1 plus minus J4. This is the pole actually, which we have calculated from this given transfer function. And after calculation of this pole, we can write HA of S will be resonant at omega is equal to 4. Here, this is omega is equal to 4. And it is needed that the digital filter must be resonant at omega r is equal to pi by 2. It is given in the problem, the resonant frequency is equal to omega pi by 2. That means digital filter must be resonant at this omega is equal to pi by 2. Hence, we will go with the relationship of the bilinear transfer function from which we can convert this analog omega into digital omega. And the equation for this, it is given, this ohm means omega here, analog omega, is equal to 2 by capital T tan of omega by 2. And from this, we can calculate this T. This is the formula which we obtained from the bilinear transfer function method. So here T is equal to 2 by omega. Omega means here the symbol of ohm in case of the analog. And this omega is the digital frequency. W type omega means digital frequency. So substituting for omega is equal to phi, which we have calculated from the pole, and omega r is equal to omega is equal to pi by 2. So in this equation, we will put this ohm, that is omega, and this omega is equal to omega r. So by putting this, we will get T is equal to 1 by 2. This means that if we select T is equal to 1 by 2, then the resonant frequency omega is equal to 4, that is ohm is equal to 4 of analog filter, will be mapped into omega r is equal to pi by 2. That is digital resonant frequency, omega r is equal to pi by 2. So this ohm, that is omega in analog, will be mapped into omega r. So here, you can see here, we can calculate this value of S in analog is replaced by this transfer function using bilinear, by putting this value of S using bilinear transformation method. S is equal to 2 by T into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. And here T is equal to, we have already calculated 1 by 2 from this formula. T is equal to 1 by 2. Then we have is equal to 4 into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. Now put this value of S in HA of S in the given transfer function. So here you can see this H of Z is equal to HA of S at S is equal to minus 4 into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. This value of S can be put into HA of S so that we will get H of Z. So here this 4, this is S plus 0.1 upon S plus 0.1 whole square plus 16. So this we have put the value of S using the bilinear transformation formula with the value of T. T is equal to 1 by 2. So we have put this value of T also, and this is the transfer function given. In that transfer function, we have put this value and calculate this H of Z. By simplifying this transfer function, we will get this H of Z is equal to 0.128 Z square plus 0.006 Z minus 0.122 upon Z square plus 0.0006 Z plus 0.075. So, 0.975, sorry. This transfer function is called as the digital transfer function, H of Z. So, from H of S, we have got this H of Z. And the from the denominator, we can calculate the values of Z. So, this Z will be equal to then minus 0.9874208, and this is e to the power plus minus j 1.5711001. So this is the value of the Z. You can plot this poles Z in the Z plane also with a unit circle. So this way we can design this IIR filter from analog filter to this digital filter, that is from HA of S to this H of Z. So this is very important to calculate or to determine the required digital filter. And this is particularly IIR filter, because here the this resonant frequency and this value is given in terms of the bilinear transformation. It is also mentioned, use this method, that is bilinear transformation method. So we must solve this problem using only bilinear transformation method. Here it is very important note also is written. We know that z is equal to r into e to the power j omega. Hence r is equal to, we have calculated this value of z, and therefore real value can be 0.987420 here, the value of r, and the omega is this value, that is 1.571110001. Hence this value can be written as is equal to plus minus pi by 2. Hence the complex conjugate poles are located at omega is equal to pi by 2. This value comes to be a pi by 2 here. In note it is given. So this is equal to plus pi by 2. Hence it is correct value. Omega is equal to pi by 2. Therefore h of z will be resonant at omega is equal to pi by 2. So this is the numerical which you can solve for the IIR filter. Very simple. Only two formulas can be used here. The formula of this Ohm is equal to 2 by t tan omega by 2. This is one most important formula for transformation of frequency from analog to digital. And another formula is this S, replacement of S in terms of Z, that is 2 by t into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. Only these two formulas are important to calculate this value. So dear friends, dear students, kindly go through the such type of problems through the standard books and from my notes also and PPT also. Next time we will see one more problem on this IIR filter. Thank you very much for listening this one, and these are the another problems which we will see next time. Thank you very much. We will see in next video, that is numerical 2. Thank you very much.